Hi everybody, thanks for watching, and welcome to another episode of Quick Tips for your Mavic Pro. Today I'd like to briefly discuss three things that I've learned while flying my Mavic Pro that I'd like to share with you. And hopefully some of the information that I can provide for you will help you when you fly yours. Today I'm going to talk about battery care, both for your Mavic Pro and its controller. I'm going to talk about the importance of calibrating your compass and where you should and should not calibrate it. And finally, I'm going to touch on the topic of flying your Mavic Pro at night. So let's get to it. First of all, you guys, I want to let you know how much I appreciate you being here. I never thought owning a drone could be so much fun, and visiting with all of you guys on a regular basis and learning from all of you makes it even that much more enjoyable. So thank you for being a loyal subscriber, and if you're not subscribed, it's a great day to join. Now, as of the taping of this video, I've been a Mavic Pro owner for about 9 months, and I have to tell you, just about every time I fly it, I learn something new. And that's why I do these videos. I want to share those things with you guys, so hopefully when you fly your Mavic Pro, you can learn from my experiences. And I try to share them in a quick, clear, and concise manner. Now, one thing that I've never been really clear on, and I've never taken the time to research until now, is that time to discharge setting on the DJI Go 4 app. Personally, I've always left it on 10 days, and I never really understood what that meant. So, what does it mean? Well, your Mavic Pro comes with lithium polymer batteries, also known as LiPo batteries. And to keep your LiPo batteries lasting for as long as possible, it's best not to store them at 100% capacity for any long period of time. You know, I don't know the science behind it, and honestly, I really don't care about the science behind it. All I care about is I want my $89 batteries to last for as long as possible. And so that's why I researched this. So it seems that the best percentage to store your LiPo batteries at are around 50%. The verdict is kind of out there. Some people say less, some people say more, but for the most part, what I've read, 50% is where you want to store your LiPo batteries for maximum life. So let's say you know you're not going to fly your Mavic Pro for 2 weeks or 3 weeks or even longer, and you're going to put it into storage. Well, you've charged up your batteries, they're at 100%. Now, you don't want your batteries to stay at 100% because that's going to decrease the total life of that battery. So what you can do is you can set that time to discharge to whatever you want between 1 day and 10 days. And what that means is when you put your Mavic Pro away, put your batteries away at 100%, and let's say you set it at 5 days. Well, 5 days from now, that battery is going to start to self-discharge. It's going to bring itself down to that optimum rate of 50% storage. Now, it takes about 2 or 3 days for that to happen. So keep that in mind, and just remember how important it is to set that setting. Now, I usually fly my Mavic Pro every 5 to 7 days or so, so I usually don't set that too long. I usually have mine around 5 days just in case I don't happen to fly it 1 week, and so it doesn't sit there at 100% for very long. But it really all depends on your guys' flight frequency. So if you fly it often, you really don't have to worry about it. But if you fly it every 2 weeks or 3 weeks or whatever, just make sure that you have that set. You know, these batteries are pretty expensive, so let's take care of them. Now, just a couple of things to keep in mind as well. You need to set each battery individual, so be sure to do that. And the second thing is, when you push that button on top of the battery to check the capacity, that's going to reset the timer, so keep that in mind too. Now, what about your controller? Well, your controller has a battery in it, and that also is a LiPo battery, which is another battery that you don't want to store for a very long time at 100%. Now, I usually charge mine right after I'm done flying. I charge it all the way up to 100%, and then I put it in my case and I put it away because I know I'm going to fly it within the next week. But if I know that I'm not going to fly for a long time, and there has been a couple of times where I haven't flown it for a couple of weeks, then what I do is I don't charge it up when I'm done flying. And usually that's about 20%, 25 or 30%. I'll put my controller away at that percentage rate, so it maintains the health of my controller battery. But for the most part, I just charge it, leave it at 100% because I fly so much. So the second thing I'm gonna talk to you guys about today is calibrating your compass. Now, we all know that we should calibrate our compass, and we realize that it's important, but how important is it and why is it so important? So I'm gonna do a little bit of a demonstration for you guys. I wanna show you guys how important it is where you calibrate your Mavic Pro. So let's do that right now. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys the importance of calibrating your compass in the right location. Now, I used to calibrate my compass for my Mavic Pro on my driveway, but we recently got a new driveway put in, and when we did that, we put rebar underneath to reinforce our driveway. Now, the problem with that is rebar is metal, and when you try to calibrate your compass with a lot of metal around, it does not work. So I'm gonna show you what happens when I move the Mavic Pro from a nice spot right now where there's not much rebar to just a foot away. So check it out. So as you can see, we got a compass error, move aircraft or calibrate compass. Now I won't be able to calibrate the compass here. It will continue to fail because there's so much metal underneath in the concrete. I'm going to show you just a little bit more detail here. I'm going to bring up the compass on the sensor state, and as you can see right now, compass one, there's 653, compass two, 465. Let's move it back to the spot where there's no rebar, and as you can see, brings it down to the green. Excellent setting. Compass one is at 32, compass two is at 32, and so there's no interference right now. So the problem with calibrating your compass on a surface like this, there's so much metal and you're never going to get an accurate calibration. So that's one of the biggest reasons that I always carry my landing pad with me, because there's a lot of places that I go where I fly where there's a lot of concrete around, there's a lot of buildings. So what I try to do, I try to go out in a wide open area, I go out into the grass, or I try to find a spot as far away from buildings as I can get. So I want to get a good compass calibration. So if I happen to have to hit that return to home button, my Mavic Pro is going to come back right where I launched it from. Okay, so why is this so important to calibrate your compass? You know, doesn't the GPS tell the Mavic Pro where to go? Well, yes and no. The GPS does know where home is, but without the compass, your Mavic Pro would be flying blind. The GPS understands a location, but it does not understand the relevance of that location without the compass. The Mavic needs a heading to follow. If you hit that return to home button and your compass isn't calibrated properly, it doesn't know which way to point the heading of the Mavic to get back to that home location. Will it get close? Probably, but I'm gonna show you, if you watch this video up here, I'm gonna post a link to the video where I crashed my Mavic Pro for the first time as I was learning how to fly it. And I'm gonna show you why it's so important when you calibrate your compass, make sure you do it in the right location. Now, the last thing that I want to visit with you guys about today is flying your Mavic Pro at night. Like I said, I've had my Mavic Pro for about 9 months and I've never flown it at night up until the other day. Now, there's two reasons that I didn't do this. Number one, I didn't really know the legality of it. I didn't know if the rules were different for flying at night than flying at day. And the second reason is, basically, you guys, I was a chicken shit. You know, I rely heavily on the obstacle avoidance, precision landing, vision positioning, all of the technology that comes with the Mavic Pro. Now, as for the legality of it, there's actually, according to the FAA, no different rules for flying at night than there are during the day. So that made me more comfortable after I read that. The second thing, as far as being scared to fly your Mavic Pro at night, you know, if you guys are worried about it, if you're thinking about doing it, but you're scared to do it, don't be scared. It's really not that bad. And actually, it's kind of relaxing to fly at night. It's really cool to see your town, to see your community from the sky at night, to see the lights, to see the cars going and all of that. You know, it was pretty awesome. But one thing to keep in mind, make sure when you do fly at night that you turn off all of your vision positioning, you turn off the obstacle avoidance and everything, because your Mavic Pro will act really funny if you leave all of that on at night. Basically, what you're doing is you're flying your Mavic Pro old school. You're flying before all of the days of the technology that comes with a Mavic Pro, and it's kind of fun. Stressful at first, but fun in the end. So I loved flying at night. I'm definitely gonna do it more. And if you guys are thinking about it, go ahead and do it, and you will enjoy it too, I promise. So that's all I have for today's quick tips video for your Mavic Pro. If you did get anything of use, anything of value out of this video, please, please consider clicking on that thumbs up button. That really helps out this channel. And if you didn't like the video and you didn't get anything out of it, please consider watching some of my other videos, in particular my quick tips videos. I'm gonna put a playlist at the end of this video. You just go ahead and click on that playlist and you can watch all of my quick tips videos or any of my other videos for that matter. Check them out. If you like them, click on that like button. If you guys have any questions about this video, about anything that I did or any of the information that I shared, please put those in the comments down below. Also, another thing, you guys, question of the day. I want to know what you guys want to see from me as far as tutorial videos or informational videos on your Mavic Pro or product reviews or whatever you can think of. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a poll right here. It should pop up. Go ahead and click on that and just pick those things right there. Help me out. You know, I do get ideas from flying my Mavic Pro, but I want to know what you guys want to see from me. So go ahead and answer that poll and help me out. Or you can put your suggestions down in the comments as well. And finally, if you're not a subscriber to this channel, you're just passing by checking out this video, please consider clicking on the subscribe button. You know, I talk about it all the time. The best part about doing this channel is the subscribers. I'm learning as much from you guys as you are from me. And I just want to make this community bigger. I want to reach 10,000 before the end of this year. So please help me do it. Share this video, put it in your playlist, click on the like button, comment, and subscribe. I want to thank you guys for watching, and as always, fly safe and fly smart.